हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम विश्वजीत नाथ। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल बेस्ट फिजिक्स गाइड बाय विश्वजीत नाथ। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ बॉडीज। लेट्स वॉच द वीडियो एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड प्लीज क्लिक द लाइक बटन। Let CD be a uniform rod having length small l, OB its center, that is CO is equal to OD is equal to l by 2. AB is an axis which is normal to CD and passing through the center of the rods O, that is OD, that is through O. Therefore, we are to find out the moment of inertia of the rod CD with respect to the axis AB. Now let lambda be the mass per unit length of the rod. Therefore, total mass of the rod CD small m is equal to L into lambda. Let dx be the length of the very small element of this rod, which is at a distance x from the axis AB, and the mass of the small element is dm. Therefore, dm is equal to lambda into dx. Now, the moment of inertia of this small element with respect to axis AB is di is equal to x square into dm, or di is equal to lambda x square into dx. Therefore, moment of inertia of the rod with respect to AB is integration of lambda x square into dx, lower limit minus L by 2 to upper limit plus L by 2. This is the moment of inertia of the whole rod with respect to axis AB. Therefore, I or moment of inertia is equal to lambda integration of minus L by 2 to plus L by 2 x square dx. This is equal to lambda by 3 x cube whole into minus lambda by 2 lower limit and upper limit plus lambda by 2. This is equal to 1 by 12 m l square, since m is equal to lambda by l. This is the moment of inertia of the rod CD with respect to the axis AB. Let ABCD is a rectangular body whose length is L and breadth is B. Its length is L and breadth is B. Now, XO X prime or Y and YO Y prime are two mutually perpendicular axes passing through the center of the rectangle O. Here, X prime axis is parallel to the length of the rectangle, that is parallel to either AB or CD. Now, we have to find out the moment of inertia of the rectangular body with respect to XO X prime axis and YO Y prime axis. Now, the moment of inertia of this body with respect to YO Y prime is 1 by 12 m l square, 1 by 12 m l square. And the moment of inertia of the body with respect to XO X prime is 1 by 12 m b square. This can be easily find out with the method which applied we in the previous section. that is moment of inertia of the rectangle with respect to y prime is 1 by 12 m l square, and with respect to x prime is 1 by 12 m b square. Let z be another axis which is passing through the point O and perpendicular to the plane of the rectangle. Now the moment of inertia of this rectangle with respect to z axis, that is Iz is equal to Ix plus Iy, that is moment of inertia of z axis with respect to z axis is equal to moment of inertia of the body with respect to x axis plus moment of inertia of the body with respect to y axis. This is equal to 1 by 12 m whole into l square plus b square. Let O be the center of the annular ring. Small a be the radius of the inner portion of the ring and small b the radius of the outer portion of the ring. Y prime be the axis which is normal to the plane of the ring. Now we have to find out the moment of inertia of the ring with respect to y prime axis. Small m be the mass of the ring and sigma be the surface density of the ring, that is mass per unit area of the ring. Therefore small m is equal to pi whole into b square minus a square bracket close into sigma. Now this is a very small portion of the ring. It is the annular portion of the ring whose center is O and radius is R, and dr is a very small width of the annular portion and its radius is dA. Now and mass of the portion, annular portion of the ring dm is equal to sigma into dA, and dA is equal to 2 pi r into dr. Therefore moment of inertia of this annular portion with respect to y prime is di is equal to r square into dm, or di is equal to 2 pi sigma r cube into dr. Therefore the moment of inertia of the whole ring with respect to y prime axis is I is equal to 2 pi sigma integration of a to b r cube into dr. This gives I is equal to 2 pi sigma by 4 into r to the power 4 into a to b, r to the power 4 a to b. This gives I is equal to sigma pi sigma by 2 into b square minus a square into b square plus a square. We know pi sigma into b square minus a square is equal to m, mass of the ring. Therefore I is equal to 1/2 into m into b square plus a square. This is the moment of inertia of the ring with respect to y prime axis. Similarly, we can find out the moment of inertia of a circular ring or a solid disk, circular disk. For a circular ring, A is equal to B. Therefore, I or moment of inertia of the ring with respect to the axis perpendicular to the plane of the ring and passing through the center of the ring is equal to M into A square, where A is the radius of the ring. And for a circular disk, here A is equal to 0. Therefore I is equal to 1/2 m b square, here b is the radius of the disk. Similarly, we can easily find out the moment of inertia of a annular cylinder whose inner radius is small a and outer radius is small b. The moment of inertia of this cylinder with respect to the axis AB, which is passing through the center of the cylinder and normal to the plane of the circular space or circular face of the cylinder, is I is equal to, or moment of inertia of the cylinder IAB is equal to half into m into a square plus b square. Similarly, for a solid cylinder, here a becomes zero, and for a hollow cylinder a is equal to b. Let this is a hollow sphere whose radius is capital R and its center is O. Capital M be the mass of the hollow sphere. Sigma be the mass per unit area of the sphere. Therefore, capital M is equal to 4 pi R square into sigma. A annular ring is considered from the body of the hollow sphere whose radius is small r and its center is O prime. Its width is R capital R into d theta. Capital R into d theta is its width. Here angle POX is theta and angle POQ is d theta. This angle is d theta. The value of d theta is very small. Now x O x prime and y O y prime are two mutually perpendicular axes. We are to find out the moment of inertia of this hollow sphere with respect to y O y prime axis. Now the mass of the annular ring is small m. Now small m is equal to 2 pi r, that is circumference of the ring, into r capital R into d theta, that is width. This gives the area of the ring into sigma. This is equal to 2 pi r square sigma cos theta d theta, since small r is equal to capital R cos theta. Therefore, moment of inertia of the ring with respect to y o y prime axis is di is equal to m into small r square is equal to 2 pi capital R square sigma cos theta d theta into r cos theta whole square. Therefore, di is equal to 2 pi capital R to the power 4 sigma cos cube theta d theta. This is the moment of inertia of the ring with respect to y o y prime axis. Now to find out the moment of inertia of the whole sphere, we are to integrate this expression. Now angle q o prime is equal to phi, that is theta plus phi is equal to 90 degree. Therefore, cos theta is equal to sin phi. Now, the moment of inertia of the hollow sphere with respect to y o y prime axis is I is equal to 2 pi sigma r to the power 4, 2 pi sigma capital R to the power 4, integration 0 to pi sin cube phi d phi. Therefore, I is equal to 2 pi sigma r to the power 4 by pi, and we know that 4 sin cube phi is equal to 3 sin x sin phi, 3 sin phi minus sin 3 phi. Now integrating, we can write that now integrating we can write that 3 into minus of cos phi minus sin 3 phi is equal to 1/3 minus of cos 3 phi. Now, since the minus sign is appeared, therefore we can reverse the limiting value. This gives I is equal to pi sigma r to the power 4 by 2 into whole into 3 cos phi minus cos 3 phi by 3, lower limit pi and upper limit is 0. Now, putting the limiting value, we get I is equal to pi sigma r to the power 4 by 2 whole into 3 minus 1/3 into 2. This gives I is equal to 4 pi sigma r to the power 4 into 2 by 3 into r square. This is equal to, we know, 4 pi sigma r to the r square is equal to m, the mass of the hollow sphere. Therefore, moment of inertia of the hollow sphere with respect to yo y prime axis is I is equal to 2 by 3 m r square. To find out the moment of inertia of a sphere, solid sphere, we consider this is a disk having radius small r, and capital R is the radius of the solid sphere, and y is the distance between the center of the solid sphere and center of the disk, and dy is the thickness of the disk. Therefore, volume of the disk is equal to pi small r square into dy, and mass of the disk small dm is equal to pi r square rho into dy, where rho is the mass density of the solid sphere. Therefore, moment of inertia of the disk with respect to y prime axis is di is equal to half r square into dm. This is equal to half r square into pi small r square rho dy. This is equal to half pi rho into r to the power 4 dy. Now we can write that r square small r square is equal to capital R square minus y square r whole square into dy. Okay. This gives half m rho r to the power 4 minus 2 r squared y square plus y to the power 4 dy. This is the moment of inertia of the disk with respect to yo y prime axis. Now, to find out the moment of inertia of the whole solid sphere, we have to integrate this expression. Therefore, the moment of inertia of the solid sphere with respect to yo y prime axis is I is equal to half pi rho integration of minus r to plus r to the power 4 minus 2 r square y square plus y to the power 4 dy. This gives half rho pi 2 into r to the power 5 minus 2 by 3 r to the power 5 plus 1 by 5 r to the power 5. Okay. This is equal to half rho 8 by 15 into r to the power 5. This is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube rho into 2 by 5 r square. This is equal to 2 by 5 m r square. This is the expression of moment of inertia of the solid sphere with respect to yo y prime axis. for today I am complete my discussion. Thank you for watching my video. Have a nice day.